Hey everybody, Marcos Villegas here, being joined with Abel Sanchez, as we're going to talk about, what do you think?
The weather?
It's nice and sunny over here in California. It's going to rain tomorrow. No, of course not. We're gonna talk about what's been in the news, something that happened with Canelo.
Oh, okay.
In regards to this Golovkin fight. First off, where were you exactly when you heard the news?
I was in my gym.
In your gym?
In my gym,
working out with everybody?
Yeah, I got a call from Tom.
Around what time was this at?
Had to have been somewhere in the afternoon because we were working out. And actually, it wasn't a call. It was a text. He said, I have some very important news. You need to call me. So I called him and...
Was Gennady working out at that time too?
I think Gennady worked out after this. It was...
So when you see a text like that from Tom, you know sums up.
No, actually, I never thought it was about Golovkin. I thought it was one of the other fighters, you know. Because Golovkin was finished. Golovkin is signed. Golovkin is training. The press conferences are over. Everything is done as far as that's concerned. So I thought it was about somebody else.
So he calls you. He tells you your feelings. How'd you feel?
Disappointed.
Did like your heart sink in your stomach a bit? Or?
No, because... you know, you read a lot of things on the internet. You read a lot of things. People say things until the experts, VADA and the commissions, decide what actually happened and what actually was done to test positive. Until they do all their tests and investigations, it'd be foolish for us to, at least for me to assume anything.
So he tells you what happened. You feel disappointed.
I feel disappointed, but I blame, to tell you the truth, I blame more the people around him, his team, than Canelo. Canelo has some blame too, but I think that his team should have been smart enough or smarter to say, listen, this is what's happening in Mexico, boom, boom, this is what's happening. So don't ingest the meat. Have some chicken, have some fish, have some a bunch of seafood until we get to wherever it is that we're going to have a training camp, or ship the meat in. The ironic thing about it is that his coaches, his managers, are in the meat business. You know, they're butchers, they're meat market owners, and that was kind of strange. Like I said, more disappointment in his team around him than in Canelo.
So you get off the phone with Tom. Do you have to go and tell Gennady now what happened, or Tom tells Gennady?
No, Gennady's resting. Gennady's kind of come down. I remember Gennady had to come down in probably another hour and a half. So no, I think that Tom called him in his room and told him what the situation was and what the next step was going to be. By the time he came down, it wasn't even discussed anymore.
No mention whatsoever. You guys didn't give each other a look like, hey.
No. He walks down. He, how you doing, G? You know, and we start. He starts working out. Starts warming up. There may have been like, you know, something like that. But it's like I said. Until the experts decide, it's bad for us to assume.
Have you guys actually sat down and talked about the situation?
Not at all. We had a media day up there. Tuesday, I think. And they asked him all the questions. They asked me all the questions. But that's the only really time we've had a time to discuss it, like I am discussing with you now. We have not discussed it because, again, he feels the same way I do. He's disappointed in Canelo. He's disappointed in his team. But he's also waiting for the experts to give us a more clear understanding of what happened or what's going to happen.
Does he believe Canelo? Do you believe Canelo?
I have no reason not to. How many fights does he have? He's got 40-some fights. And he hasn't tested positive before. So I have no reason not to, but of course we all have our ideas and suspicions, I guess you could say.
You have suspicions though, even though all this, you have a suspicion or no?
Of course you have to be suspicious, but again, I'm a coach, man. I, for me to assume that this is what it is and this is, you know, he's been doing it forever, be stupid. He's been tested, I'm sure, at least 100 times in his history. And he's never tested, so this is the first time. Hopefully everything's okay.
If this would have happened on the other side, with you guys...
Fight suspended.
Okay, that's what I was getting to.
Yes.
Do you think the fight should keep on going, or do you think it should be put on hold?
I think it depends on the experts. But if it's Golovkin that did it, it wouldn't be the experts that would suspend the fight. It'd be Golden Boy, because they don't want the fight. But they know it's the fight they have to fight. I think we wouldn't be talking right now. It'd be suspended.
So is there a way, any sort of like resentment towards that?
No. No, because there always has to be, they can never be just like in, let's just say the Rocky movies. There was a fighter and a B fighter. In every fight, there's a fighter, and we're trying to be that A fighter with Golovkin. We understand that Canelo has posted better numbers on pay-per-view. We understand all that. In order for us to get to that point, we have to climb the mountain and beat that guy convincingly, maybe convincing the people's eyes so that we take over that mantle. But to be jealous of that, no. There's no resentment. There's no. I just hope that Canelo is clean and the fight goes off and we can prove who the best man is.
You and the team, what do you guys want to see from this point forward in terms of that situation and clearing it up?
Investigation, for sure. That is not swept under the rug.
How so?
Vada, whether it be hair follicles, whether it be him providing information on where he ate, where it was bought, if it was in a restaurant, where that restaurant bought that meat. It's very easy to do that. If you go back to the dates that he tested positive, you know, it could be a week and a half that he ingested that, and go back and the timeline, find out the timeline. And then once that is determined that it is or it isn't, and the fight goes on, I think that he needs to be tested more stringently than he has been, just to prove not only to us but to the fans that he's a clean fighter.
There's so many things to talk about this issue, but in terms of Gennady, does it make him want to go out there and prove more because of this? Does it change his mindset at all?
No, I don't think so. I think that what is motivating him tremendously right now is the fact that he got robbed in the first one. He didn't get the glory of being the winner when he did win. So I think that's the motivation for him right now. That this comes about, he just hopes, I know in talking to him, and listening to him, I should say, in the interviews, he just hopes that he's proven to be a clean fighter, Canelo is, and that the fight goes off.
I saw something about the hand wraps. What was that all about?
There was an issue with the wraps prior to the last fight. The wording in the hand wrap rule is very vague, but it is known, and you can talk to the commissioner here in California, and they'll tell you that it is extremely unfair and unhealthy, and it is not allowed here in California. They did a type of wrap where it's called stacking. And that's been illegal throughout the world, throughout the United States for sure. California, New York, they don't allow you to do that. In fact, when I came in yesterday for the meetings with the commission, I said, just so you know, Mark, tomorrow I'm going to put a stacking kind of rep. I said, no, you're not. You won't be able to fight if you do. That is completely illegal here. It will never be allowed. So that the Nevada Commission chooses to interpret the rules in a way that is to the letter, I think it's a little unfair to fighters that are trying to do things the right way.
Why didn't you say anything before about the stacking?
Because we had a meeting, Tom Loeffler and I had a meeting with Mr. Bennett and the two inspectors in the dressing room, one in ours and one in Canelo's. The one in Canelo's is the one that I protested to. There's video, five cameras that were videotaping me, my protest to him that's illegal, you cannot do that. And they continue. And he told me to be quiet or he was going to kick me out of the room. I've always said that, unfortunately, in this business, some commissions have preferential treatment to some fighters. Maybe they're the cash cow that brings money into the town. I don't know. But to say that to me, that just tells me that you really don't care about my opinion. Instead of calling your superior in to talk about it, you threaten to kick me out. I think that that's preferential treatment for particular fighters. I've never been an advocate of anybody getting an edge over somebody else. If you're a 4-round fighter, treat me the same way as you do the 12-round fighter or the coaches. And I didn't say nothing because Mr. Bennett promised that he would dig into it and find out what was the his decision. And he had not, to this day, that was back in September, and to this last couple days, he had not contacted us in letter or in text or in email or in phone call. So I thought I needed to, now that the fight's coming up, I thought I needed to say that so that people know.
You worried the night of the fight it's going to be an issue again?
No, because I hope to get it resolved way before the night of the fight. It is, like I said, the wording is very vague. The wording is very, how can I put it? It's not even telling you exactly what you need. It actually tells you that you can use this much and this much, but doesn't tell you the application. Everybody that wraps hands or that's in this business knows that that's an illegal act. Now, if you can get away with it, great for you, but it's not fair to the other fighter. Great for you, I say, because you got away with it, but it's not a level playing field.
On a final topic over everything that's transpired with this situation, at the end of the day, are you surprised something like this happened, given this sport of boxing, the test?
I'm very surprised. I'm very surprised because I believe that Canelo's probably the biggest name that's ever been tested positive. There's a lot of suspicions about a lot of other great fighters, but...
You just hear so much from so many athletes in combat sports that this is not a clean sport, that a lot of people are on stuff.
That's unfortunate. As I was saying to somebody else, the U.S. Or the governments of the world are always trying to catch counterfeit moneymakers, right? They make money, and the counterfeiters are always one step ahead of the governments. It seems like in this case also, the steroid users, the dirty fighters, the suppliers of this bad thing are always one step ahead of the testers. They always have one, and the fighters believe it, and things happen. They get caught. I'm not saying Canelo is, but there have been other fighters. Shane Mosley admitted to using. He wasn't aware that whatever cream he was using was going to do that. That we're using the excuse of the meat in Mexico. You have to be under a rock the last 10 years not to know that there's a problem down there for. So the excuse is kind of lame. But again, the experts need to determine that the full extent of his involvement with it.
Hey, well, thank you for clearing that up and giving your thoughts on it. Abel Sanchez, of course, big fight ahead of him. May 5th, T-Mobile Arena, Las Vegas, Nevada, Gennady Golovkin against Canelo Alvarez.